This time around for the month of August, first time in the history of this event, we have two winners. So it's a tie there. So I would just like to announce the names. So it is Sayali and Radhika. So I would first like to call Sayali forward. And now I would request her trainer, Vijaya, to please hand over the certificate to her. She'll also give the letter of appreciation. So now I would request Sayali if she could discuss or she could tell her experience with Girish.
Wanting to learn this PM thing for a very long time, and I was not sure ki how should I go about it. And then while searching on the internet, I found about CAD and I enrolled for it, and the experience was quite helpful, where I got to learn a lot of things on the softwares. So and I really had a good experience over here, and currently I'm doing my internship with XS CAD. So that is also quite interesting because just I'm able to apply all the knowledge that I've learned so far and the, how to use it practically. So that is the good thing about it. So
that's okay, so I would just like to request her to if you can just share her project with her. Yes?
So I haven't done any major changes in the site, but I did a few changes internally. This is the ground floor. This is LOD 100. So here in this part, I have done some changes. Like the toilet was given over here, and the pantry and the canteen was inside. So I flipped it. So I got a bigger space for the canteen, and the toilets were shifted inside. This is the second floor plan. Here I have given an additional amenity of a gym. Conference room, let me show you. This is the terrace. So one part I've given a informal sitting, whereas the other part I've given formal sitting.
Okay, so thank you, Sayali, and congratulations to you. I would like to call upon Vijaya, and if she can share her experience with Sayali and some words of wisdom as well.
Hello, everyone. Congrats to both Radhika and Sayali on becoming student of the month. Coming to Sayali, she is hardworking and creative. She used to complete all the given assignments on time, and she had a clear idea how what all the changes she wanted to implement on the projects. She has attended the Student of the Month event in July, and after attending it, she was very keen to become one. So she, here she is. Congrats once again. Thank you.
Okay, so thank you, Vijaya. Thank you, Sayali. So the next, I would like to call upon Radhika. She can just come in the center. And again, I would like to call upon Khyati to hand over her certificate and also the letter of appreciation. I would now request Radhika if she can share her project.
Select one of the project, whatever they give, but I requested to do my project because right now I'm doing my master's in Australia in Bonn, so I've come here for like a visit, so I did the class because their Revit is very important. So I just asked her like, can I go with my project, because I had the project with me, and then she said like, yeah, you can. So basically the project is about the floating villa. And the floating villa is basically we got a site where it was we were given two pontoons, so like floating in the water, and we have to build a bungalow on that, on the pontoons. So we had there were many features like related to water. The structure is correlating with water. So I wanted to do that experiment to learn the water textures and all everything. So yeah, that's my project, and now I'll start. So that's, I was saying, like the site, and this the entire thing is the water, and these are the pontoons which we were given, and we had to build lightweight structures. So this is the one which I had designed, and like this is the site plan, and now I'll go ahead with the furniture layouts. So basically this is my ground floor plan.
where the entrance is from here, and then you just come inside. This is the car parking, and that's the entrance to one pontoon, which is being connected by the glass bridge to the another pontoon. So the concept was basically the one residential connected to your working zone. So it's like an isolated thing, so both were together. So that's my residential zone, and that's my professional or commercial zone. So initially the thing was about the three people living in the villa. So one was the male was the doctor, like, and so he has his clinic on the ground floor, and the female was a fashion designer, so she has her own fashion studio on the first floor. So this is the ground floor layout. So here we have a bit of features additional to the water thing. So that's the entry, this is the living room, and this is the open deck, and here I have basically a facade of terracotta, which will like the water will be running, and that is the reason here there is a cutout where the water will just flow. And in Rajasthan this concept has been developed, like if it is a terracotta wall, the water, and there is a flowing water, and if the air passes, it gives an aircon feeling in the space. So that was a natural aircon thing which I had to put here. So this facade was a terracotta facade, and this was a cutout for the flowing water so that air can pass, and then you can get an airconic feeling in the living space. And this is also a cutout, but I have a glass flooring where you feel like you are to get the effect of the water. So then this was the kitchen area, which you have like a total open kind of feel. And then I'm moving in the bedroom, the master bedroom, where you have one more feature, like this is a balcony, and then you have the step downs in the water. So you are basically with the railing, of course. I'll definitely show you the view of that. So that is like, you know, you can sit on the steps and you can actually be in the sea water, and but still in your villa. So that was one of the features. Then this was a connecting bridge, and here is a clinic, and here is a pool area. And yeah, so as I go up, this was my first floor with materials set. So this was basically, again, I come first floor, so this was a fashion studio. And here is that, this was a living room on the ground floor, and here is the open, like double height. So basically a female is always attached to her house, so for her it's like a quick moment where she can just go and see what's going on, like a communication space, interaction space was being created. So then that was thing, and then this was a storeroom, and this is the child's bedroom, and then this was the balcony. Yeah. And yeah, that was the basement where it was under, submerged under the water. So basically I created that area as like a theater room, and this as a relaxing room where this is the pool area. So you can just have a look of the pool, like people swimming, and plus a relaxing room. So these were the layouts, the furniture layouts. These are the dimension layouts as per the requirement. Then this was a ceiling layout, where I created one ceiling with the cuts and the lights, and the ceiling lights, and rest was a normal ceiling. Yeah, that was a colorful legend which was there in the requirements. These were the tag layouts. Yeah, and that was my elevation. So I think it will be visible in the section on elevation. Yeah, this is the basement. This is what I was talking about, the terracotta designed wall and double height. And this is the communication space. That's my kitchen. And then I step down for the bedroom, so that step down the water, so I can get that feature of the outdoor space. And that's the basement. And the other sections, elevations. Yeah, just a moment. This was the feature I was talking about, the step down.
and then you can just rest here and have a sea infinity view. Yeah, these are the external views. This is the terracotta, that wall. That was the feature, like step down. These are the external views. Yeah, that was the view. So you can see the water effect, submerged, half submerged. These are the internal room. This is the living space room with the terracotta thing. Yeah. This was the ceiling which I was talking about, like having the cuts and the lights, light effects. And these are the day views of the bedroom, living room, and the kitchen, the open kitchen, the dining. And this was a master bedroom, which I had this one more design feature of ceiling. And I had the bathroom with a glass wall. So you can see the internal of the bathroom also. Yeah, these are basically the day views of this thing. I kept the total mirror so that the room is spacious and it looked good. These are the night views of the kitchen and the bedroom. That's the living room in the night view. These are the external night views.
Thank you, Radhika, and congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Would really like to see this project come to reality.
Okay,
sure. So now I would request Khyati if she can come forward and share her experience. And
just a moment. I can't share the experience with the
Yes, 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 why not? Please.
Okay. So, yeah, the Briar's experience was really good. And initially I was searching on the net and I liked the ambience very first thing, where I just felt like, you know, I want to go ahead with this. And the teaching was amazing, all thanks to Carrie. Like, I had a phobia of softwares, so she really helped me out with this phobia. And when I enrolled, the day I enrolled, I had seen this student of the month, and I was like, wow, that's like very good motivation to come up and just work hard. And definitely she used to motivate every time, and I really like the way they teach, like in terms of just not her teaching, but in terms of like the way they give the workbook, so that you get quite used to for whatever you learn. To complete the workbooks on time really help you to remember everything, because whatever you do it right there itself, so that that feeds in your mind. So that helps a lot when you do your own project. So I really like the workbook system and the test system, like the weekly test, and amazing teaching, of course. And I would really thank my partner, who really motivated me, Vishal, who, like, because of him I could get the motivation and work hard and help him. Like, even he helped me a lot. So yeah, the entire credit goes to her and him. Thanks a lot.
Okay, so thank you, Radhika. Your experience really speaks a lot. So now, Khyati, please share your words of wisdom with us.
Hello everyone, good morning and a very warm welcome to everyone. All of you are new over here, so this is quite new for you. I think you all are motivated now to do better, right? So talking about Radhika, as she said, she had a phobia of softwares. She already told me, for the first day she told me that, you know, even working on AutoCAD, it is very difficult for me, because if I say, like, no, you know this command, okay, I know, but I am not sure, like, that way. So I was very scared, like, how she will cope up with this Revit, which is so vast, like, you know, working with the project browser, so many views, so many, you know, features of Revit. But of course, she made her efforts. She used to work here, practice here extra. Further, she used to always go home and do the practical things. She used to come with the workbook exercises, like, you know, I have done this with all the requirements which were set. Further, she came up with this floating villa concept where she wanted to do for the final project. I was again worried whether she will be able to do or not, frankly. But then she made efforts. She used to come here, ask the doubts, you know, how to make this water kind of effect. And mostly that is a fear, like, you know, how to make that floating effect, water effect, using building pads and on the side, etc. So yes, she made efforts. She has done very nicely. And finally, yes, she was chosen as the student of the month. So do your best. In any field, like, you people are from MEP, so you will not have these renderings and all those things, but of course you can do your requirements which are set, and you know, yes, you can be one of them. Thank you.
Just to wrap up, I hope you all enjoyed this as much as we did putting it up for you. So thank you all for coming, all the participants, thank you. And in the end, again, I would just like to say, whatever I started with, हिम्मत मत छोड़िए और कोशिश करते रहिए. थैंक यू.